Intro. Fallout, like a lot of long-running franchises, has evolved a lot over the decades. From the classic story-driven, isometric turn-based, to the modern combat-focused first-person shooter, the quirky idle app, or even the malign top-down shooter, they've tried a lot. Why not try to make a tabletop game while they're at it? With Fantasy Flight behind the wheel, a company known for some impressive licensed games like Arkham Horror the Card Game and Star Wars Imperial Assault, there was a pretty good chance that they'd come up with something real fun. Opening up the box, you can tell that they didn't skimp on production value. The graphics, the miniatures, the cards, the caps! The best part has to be the player board that emulates an in-game Pip-Boy, with places for your equipment and an XP track. It's a big, heavy box packed with a lot of exciting components. Even if the game ends up not being that good, as a Fallout fan, these components are nice enough objects on their own, which is good because, well, the systems. Looking through the setup, all 9 steps of it, you can't help but think, wow, there's a lot going on here. And you're right, there are a lot of systems at play. With a game as huge as Fallout, there was bound to be a lot of mechanics to include as much of the video game as possible. There's exploration, shopping, currency, combat, equipment, companions, quests, XP and leveling. All the fun Fallout mechanics. Only, they're maybe not as fun as you'd expect. Sure, there's a big procedurally generated map, but there isn't much to find out there. All of the scenario's specific locations are visible from the beginning anyway, so you're mostly searching for fan service. Oh boy, can't wait to stumble on the Red Rocket Station! I've heard of that place! Combat uses the gorgeous custom VATS dice, but it really comes down to a single die roll. Or 2 die rolls with a weapon. The dice are also pretty unsatisfying with how clunky they are to read. It feels less, yes, got him! And more, that, hold on, yeah, that got him. Oh, you want to spend some time with the companions you love from the video games? Well, enjoy these flat portraits of their in-game model with a vaguely related ability. It's like I'm really there! When I got Fallout and started digging into it, and read its large rules reference and punched out all these pieces, I was excited for the deep, heavy experience ahead of me. However, spending half an hour to set it up each time felt like my time was being wasted. Half the components go completely unused in most of the games I've played. The shop rarely, if ever, gets activated. And when it does, the player rarely has enough caps to do anything there. Good thing I have so many. You almost never use more than 1 or 2 of the super mutants, monsters, or robots. The only trait that regularly shows up is well-rested. Most of the map is empty and unused, and saddest of all, only a handful of quests really ever come up in most games. I've played this game so many times, and I don't feel like I've ever gotten more than a tiny nibble of any of the potentially juicy storylines hidden away in the card library. So many of these components feel less like they were something someone actually wanted to include, and more like a mandate from Bethesda, or worse, a fix slapped on for a fiddly mechanic. The challenge of adapting for tabletop. So, with all of the production value and a solid franchise as a foundation, what went wrong? Well, quite a few things, but it all really comes down to one thing: scope. Fallout is a huge game. Even the old games on primitive hardware were massive, expansive worlds with deep mechanics. Because it's Fallout, they had to include all of these things in the tabletop game. But because it's tabletop, they had to find a way to do so without making a game so enormous that it could never possibly be sold. Since they didn't want to use an app, the way some board games of this size have, all of these systems had to be abstracted in a way that can be compelling while still maintaining the spirit of the thing being abstracted. For fear of leaving Fallout fans dissatisfied, they included far too many systems and created something that can only be described as shallow bloat, rather than focus on a few and make them all robust and satisfying. It created this terrible mess of thin disks spinning uselessly on top of each other, rather than a few chunky cogs churning along. Plus, because it's a tabletop game that you'd be playing with other people, they felt the need to make it multiplayer and competitive, which is just incredibly futile. Being Fallout, this game so desperately wants to be played as a single-player experience. But instead, it's several single-player experiences crammed together where the only real interaction you have is stealing a quest from someone else. You might not have even meant to do so because, get this, you can actually accidentally complete a quest. That's how anemic the storytelling is, that you can do a random, unrelated action and completely change the course of events. The events in the video game might not always have involved incredibly complicated endeavors on your part, But it at least felt like what you did was in some way related to what was going on. Focus and motivation. The worst system by far is influence and agenda. This is the win condition, which should be the most clearly compelling mechanic in the game. Instead, not only is it mostly arbitrary, like how many caps you have, how many tiles you've explored, or, most commonly, which faction is furthest ahead, but in every game I've played, everyone forgets about it completely. Those playthroughs have all gone on for 2, 3, 4 turns after they've ended, because we all forgot to check the 3 cards tucked under the corner of our player board. This begs the question, what is the focus in this design? It could be the story, but your actual involvement in the story is minimal. Could be the combat, but that's just obtuse and anticlimactic. Could be the agendas, but they're easily forgotten and rarely have anything to do with what you're actually doing in the game. That's really the whole problem here. None of the systems are deep enough to be a focus, and none of them connect enough to make a cohesive experience. They're all just general Fallout-y ideas that don't feel like they were ever fleshed out. It's a strange combination of the classic Fallouts in interface and the Bethesda Fallouts in theme. Trying to weave multiple single-player experiences into one game while removing any depth from the stories and personality from the world, and providing no real motivation to accomplish anything of consequence, means that this is less Fallout New Vegas and more Fallout 76. In summary, in the end, the only thing heavy about Fantasy Flight's Fallout is its physical weight. When everything is stripped away and actual gameplay comes to light, it's about as deep as Talisman. At least Talisman has an app that can do the setup for me. Hundreds of cards and tokens can't hide the fact that this game isn't compelling. It's just long and spread too thin, as big and empty as the wasteland it depicts. Every bit of the experience is a quick spark of fun that can't find its way to starting a fire. A huge pile of mediocre systems combined does not make for a single strong game or avoid the reality that, without the Fallout theme, this game likely never would have seen the light of day. Sometimes, I remember the fun I had when I first played Fallout. I was still relatively new to tabletop games, and was just happy to play with all of these flashy pieces. I think, oh man, I should really dig into that. Play through the whole story, get every bit of content out of it. But then I remember the time I'd spend getting out all of these parts that I'd literally keep in a tackle box to make setup bearable. I think about how I've barely skimmed the outer edges of the quest lines before the factions ended things. Or I unceremoniously got the last influence I needed to win. I think about how long I've spent just parsing combat results. When that all comes back to me, I think that I'd rather just play the real Fallout. At least there, I might find a story of my own.